mix day, 10:08 a.m. and we are on the way to the beach. So I will see you down there, and yes, I'm showered and in different clothes. Yeah. So yeah. Here we go to the beach. Alright, first day at the beach. Alexis covering up her sand. Right by the lifeguards. Going. So pretty. What?
What?
You have sand like everywhere. Tell me when I can stop. And there's a boardwalk. Everything is boardwalks there, aquarium down at the end of the
when
boardwalk.
I'm covered, you can stop.
I'm gonna set it somewhere because I just wanna like relax and get a drink. I don't wanna have to film. Cool umbrella rental for the guy stuck in the sand for us. Glad I have an umbrella. Yeah, I don't have to hold it.
Okay, just tap record.
Okay, it's filming now. Do you want me to? Is there a way to make it like closer up?
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Oh, cool. You can see them out there on their surfboard. Okay, got it. Oh, look, he's standing up on it. That's good, just to be able to stand up on it. How much do you want? There's someone parasailing over there. Is that parasailing? Okay, should I stop now?
Yeah.
Alright, so do you want to do it? Yeah, hold on. Lexi goes. Yeah, where's the elevator that goes upstairs for the seal feedings?
So this is for handicap.
You can't get cat feed just like you and me, so we make sure that we brush your teeth every single feeding. No, however, seals do have a bite force that's twice as powerful as a pit bull, so you never want to approach these guys in the wild. They also have very long claws on both their side fingers.
Can you see her? Can you see through there?
We do cut those regularly just to ensure her health. See, Lucy is a seal, not a sea lion. Sea lions have longer claws. Lucy has two little ones on the side. And when she would want to walk, she would kind of inch along like an inchworm. The sea lion would be able to walk upright. Also, sea lions can vocalize by barking. When Lucy wants to vocalize, it kind of sounds like she has a frog cut her throat.
Stop
back in the water.
You guys might have noticed that Lucy does have a red film over her eye. That's called a stress cataract. She got that after the stress caused by her accident.
Oh, yeah. That's how my eyes are.
Humans from overfishing and oil pollution in the water. The best that we as normal people could do is to recycle, make sure to buy ocean-safe products or ocean-safe fish. So the video will continue for the next few moments. I hope you guys have a wonderful day here at James' Aquarium, and our next feeding will be our Atlantic Shark Tank at 4 o'clock.
Is lost.
Daddy, you can peek inside here and see what.
Oh, really?
Looks like it's underwater almost. So we're so close.
Daddy, see where she's going?
Yeah, it does.
Horseshoe crab. It's working its way down there.
Behind the
look at it. So he wants to get out. Here he comes.
Not yet. We have to wait for her to see the other way.
I'm sorry. I'm going to go in front of you like that.
Oh, this is
cute. I didn't see that. I was like, why don't you take a picture of
it? I don't see
anything.
You can see the thing before you touch. And then on this side, just stick your arm in the tray. And on this side, don't stick your whole arm
in.
Don't go past your
wrist.
Did it get you?
No. Did it get me? We want to stay till 4 to see the sharks get fed.
Yeah.
It's making its way down to the right. It's coming by the other guy. It's coming by the other one. Oh, there's a bunch of.
Oh, look, there's a bunch of crabs in there, too.
Crabs.
Oh, look at the sail.
You got him, Sim. Stick his head out. Our figures can come out for your video. Alright, we go. Spotted turtles.
Exactly match my swimsuit.
How cute. There's one up here. Hello. Alright, let's go over here. Look at these huge ones over there. It's sleeping on a rock. I like these guys. Alright, let's go. Let's walk over here. Come over here. You see the big ones. I get it. Sounds better. You good?
Yeah.
Here, come on. It's still filming. These ones. Where are they around? This one's swimming down here. Come here. Over here. Side step over. There you go. Look. It's big. What are these? These are northern diamondback terrapins. It's a northern diamondback. Looks like we're swimming underwater with them, huh? Delete it. You could edit these too, right?
Yeah.
So I'm not sure to
watch. What's this shark?
Yes, I know, but that one's very similar.
What is that shark?
You know what I mean? They all
look similar.
They are. One's a different color than the other ones.
Can I see closer? Although he could sit in there, Tim, film, and it'd be like they're right there. I don't think I've ever been this close to a shark before. Here he is. Check it out. That's so cool. Oh my gosh, that is the biggest school of fish I've ever seen. Look! That's so awesome. Look how big these fish are. See lots of schools of tiny fish? Look how big, look how long that one is. Those are a big school of fish. Wow. Check it out, Lex. Okay, I gotta get this on my phone too. This is like so awesome.
This is like the coolest thing right here. You're just still filming. Should I turn it off?
Yeah.
You got it?
Coming.
Swimming, they think we're seals. It's mistaken identity, basically. They don't know what humans are. are. They're just looking for a meal, and we're splashing in the water. They think we're a seal that's injured, because that's what we sound like. And they're very particular eaters. They like to eat with their babies. So what they do is hold an investigative bite, a test bite, a taste bite, whatever you want to call it, but it's just to see what they're going to eat. They want to make sure it's going to taste good to them. Luckily for us, we do not taste it.
Wow.
So once they take a bite of us, they don't really stick around looking at the top. They just taste us and they're out of there. Now our sharks are being fed quite a variety of food. We're giving them some bunker, butterfish, squid, mackerel, herring, sometimes capelin.
Oh.
And they'll be eating at the poles. Here you watch when the poles come down to the aquarium. They send them at the top of the sand at the end of what they call.
Sorry.